just to be a nice meet you.
One more.
I think it's always just been part of us as humans to have that curiosity to go further. For decades now, we've been collecting physiological data to try to understand how the human body is affected by the spaceflight environment.
You know, being in space for a year, it's a really long time.
The physical aspects of coming home, you feel heavy, you feel dizzy, out of balance, nauseous.
What Scott did while he was up there for a year, you know, he was a subject for a wide variety of physiological and medical studies.
I did this so many times in space, it's not even funny.
A lot of scientists all around the country and around the world are spending a lot of time looking and trying to understand the effects of that one-year mission on Scott.
I'm just the lab rat. I'm the guinea pig.
Scott has an identical twin brother that wasn't subjected to that year in space, so we can start looking at other levels of changes as well.
This study with my brother and I is really important right now because it will help us get to Mars someday.
It looks comfy.
When we go to Mars, we look at it as sort of a three-year mission. We really need to make sure that as scientists, as physiologists, we have a good understanding of what that is going to do to the human body. I think without risk, there is no reward. And I know that as astronauts, we are willing to accept maybe a slightly level higher risk than somebody else is. But to us, it's totally worth it because we're not just doing it for ourselves. We're really doing it for all mankind.
My hopes is, you know, someone watches this show and they get an appreciation for the space station, what it's like after returning from a really long flight, and, you know, what that might mean to our future.